Hi guys, it's me Sherry with Live Love Latte, and I thought I'd show you in the next few videos some of the binders that I've been putting together to help me keep organized. And I decided about a couple months ago, let me try to start couponing. I just ran across a few YouTube channels specifically geared towards couponing, and I found a couple that I really liked and have helped me to be motivated to start. And one of them is C. Sigler Save, and the other one is Healthy Prepper, and I'm going to put the links to their channels below. Now, C. Sigler Save has made it a little bit easier than some other channels that I've seen, and especially if you're just beginning to coupon and it seems very overwhelming, it's a great channel. Anyway, just thought I'd plug her in there because it really has helped me. And a few other websites that I found also are Living Well, Spending Less, Coupon Divas, and My Crazy Coupon Lady. So I wanted to show you my binder. This is a 3-inch Staples Better Binder, and I've always started using the Better Binder after seeing it recommended by Alejandra Castello on home organizing. You see, I like the color pink, and I've just labeled it my coupon binder. And I got this whole system from My Crazy Coupon Lady, and you can just get it at their website. Here you just have your name, and I've covered my phone number, and they're basically 40 categories. Four of them you can just write your own example. I put some for auto and dining out. Maybe you have some other categories you can think of, but those are two of the categories I put in the blank ones. And so I use this as my cover sheet. It's kind of like the table of contents, and they don't really give like categories for the binder tab. So I just looked at the table of contents and thought, okay, what are some categories that I could divide these into? So when you open it up, here on the left, I have put this large binder clip because this doesn't come with a clipboard. And so I just put loose leaf paper here for my shopping list. I have three different clear plastic pencil pouches. Here for my supplies, I have a little pink calculator. I mean, you can get these for like a dollar at Walmart. Some scissors for coupon cutting, and I do have some highlighters and some pens. And then also what I have, so here, I like highlighters, by the way, that are the ones that you can press like that. It's just easier for me than taking off the cap and putting it on the back, using it, and then taking off the cap again and putting it back on. I just love that. Okay. And I do the same thing for my pens. I usually try to look for ones that are the push ones. And then I've put a little magnifying glass in here because sometimes it's getting harder for me to read the fine print of the coupons. And then over here for the pink one, now it says for shopping. So at this point, I was kind of hesitant to get a 3-inch binder. I started with a 1.5-inch binder. And trust me, it does not fit. It has to be at least a 2 to 3 inch binder. So this is a 3-inch, but I thought, you know, I don't wanna take this to the grocery store, put it on top of my shopping cart. I know people do that, but for me, it just seemed really bulky. I have a big purse anyway, and I didn't wanna just add more weight than necessary. So what I did is to take one of these. And so when I make my shopping list and I do my planning, and you can read all that, especially on Living Well, Spending Less, she has a great coupon guide for beginners. So what I do after I make my list, I get the coupons that I need, I stick them in here with my shopping list and the coupons, and I have an extra pen just to cross out the stuff that I get in my shopping list. And so this is all I have to bring to the grocery store. Now, this takes planning, and I've done 2 shopping trips, and it's taken me about an hour to plan, looking through the coupon matchups, putting my list together, getting the coupons together. I have this for loose coupons. Sometimes I have like these CVS coupons that I didn't want to put in a category over there because I'll be using these more often. And if like the grocery store gives you a coupon upon checkout, I could put it in here really quickly. Then from here, I can always take these and then organize them into my coupon binder. Although the CVS ones I kind of keep in here. I could make that a whole category, but again, I've been trying to use these more. And it's just easier for me there. And so I've just divided the categories into produce. I probably use about 15 categories. And then I just use their printout. You can see that. And then I have baseball cards here. And I tried to put like 3 per section. Snacks. So here's another one. They have salty snacks. And I mean, if you don't mind having this tagline up here, it looks really pretty. I like the design that they put on it, and then the font I think is really pretty. So here's some of the coupons I've already cut out. Granola bars. Okay, so that's one category. Another category is fruits and veggies. Pasta, medicine, personal care. And that personal care takes care of the beauty, oral care, soap, hair care, lotion, shaving, feminine hygiene. And then another category is pets. Another one is dining, and then auto. So those are my categories. I got this from, I think, My Crazy Coupon Lady on their YouTube channel. And what they did is they suggested to just put into the sheet protectors the insert. So instead of having to go through every coupon and cutting it out one by one, which I do, but if you want to have when there's double coupons and triple coupons, all they said was to write the date of the insert, see, 9/15, September 15. And then I took one of these that I have in my other binders. You can get these from Staples. They're a 3-ring binder poly envelope. It has Velcro. And then I just labeled it red plum for the red plum insert. And then you just stick them in there. So when you do the coupon matchups, it'll say red plum, September 15. So I just go to red plum, pull out the September 15 one, and cut out the specific coupon. So that is a faster way of doing it. And then another coupon insert is Smart Source. So that's in a different color poly envelope. And then I have this at the back. Right now, I don't need that for anything. So anyway, that's my coupon binder. And this probably took me 3 hours to put this together. And the reason it took, I mean, probably the binder itself, figuring out the categories, putting all the tabs in, printing out the categories, that probably took an hour and a half, and probably the other hour and a half was taking the coupons that I had cut out already and putting them into the baseball card holder. So I'd say it's a 3-hour project. It's worth it because now I'm completely organized. I'm reading the Living Well, Spending Less website, and that has just been absolutely fabulous. I watched C. Sigler Save just to keep me motivated and encouraged and see what she's doing. So I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you're going to start couponing I hope this helps you. If you're already couponing, please, please put any comments below that you think would help me, as I'm just a beginning couponer and I'd love to have your input and your advice. Okay, until next time, happy organizing and hope you enjoy your weekend.
Click the subscribe button to stay up to date with our latest videos. Like us on Facebook, pin with us on Pinterest, and check out our blog, Live Love Latte, Inspired Organized.